Hi, I'm Dave.
And I'm Craig.
And this is the Wizard Product Review. It's 12 o'clock on a Wednesday on this week's show.
Did it again.
Yeah, I know. I changed the order around.
Yeah.
Okay, first up this week, you intro it.
Okay, first up this week,
it's
we have...
coin trick.
Yeah. Alex Pandrea's Coin Waltz from the Blue Crown and New York Magic Project.
Cool.
And basically what it is it's Doc Eason's anniversary waltz, but done with coins. So the idea is, in performance, Alex borrows a quarter. He takes the quarter, he gets someone to put their initials on it. He then takes another quarter, gets another person to put their initials on it. He holds the coins right here at the tips of the fingers. And this is so visual. He goes, watch and don't blink. Boom. And in that second, the coins fuse together into one coin. And the tips of his fingers, he can show his hands completely empty. He turns it round. The two coins have fused together into one. And he gives them away as a souvenir.
It's the same coin. It's the same design of coin, though, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. You know,
it's not like... Because when I first read about this, I thought it was like one coin on one side and
another coin on the other.
When I first read it, that's what it was.
Whatever coin you're going to have to use, you're going to have to use the same type of coin. So if you're using quarters, you have to use two quarters. In England, if you're using £2 coins, you're going to have to use £2 coins. You can use any coin you want to, but it's got to be the same coin for both.
Right. What did you reckon to it?
I like it. I really like it. I mean, come on. The anniversary waltz plot is a classic for a reason.
Yeah, but it's not
really
that.
It really connects with the audience.
But it's not that. It's a coin trick.
No. I know it's a coin trick. But even though it's a coin trick, it works. It works. It works really, really well, even though it's a coin trick. You've still... The moment where the two coins fuse together into one, it's more visual than the card, you know, than when you do it with playing cards. Because you actually... With playing cards, they hold it between their hands. With the coins,
yeah,
you've actually
between
got that...
Between their hands is better than you doing something, like, flashy in your
hands. No. You've got that visual moment when they just go, boom.
But you do know... You do know, in real life, though, you don't have that sound effect that goes... like on the video,
no, you don't.
So I've noticed that every time he does it, he goes,
I know,
and it makes it look a little bit better.
Unless you carry a little tape recorder around, maybe get some sort of.
I thought it was okay. I thought it was good. I think it's a good trick. I think Alex is a fantastic magician.
Oh, he's awesome. He really is.
But
he's awesome.
This trick is. So, I don't think I'd do it.
I think
it's good.
Just so you know, it's very, very... Even though Alex is incredibly talented as a performer, and you can do some really difficult stuff, the routine itself is actually very easy.
You get a gimmick, don't you?
You get a gimmick. Well, you don't get a gimmick. You have to make the gimmick in a kind of a mini paper crane moment.
You get the bits to make the gimmick.
Yeah, and you make it up. It only takes about 10 minutes to make up. Once it's made up, you're set to go whenever you want to. It won't take up any pocket space. Whenever you want to perform the routine, you're ready to perform it. It's an instant reset. There's very little angles to worry about.
Very little angles? You sure about that?
Yeah, no, seriously, yeah.
Even if you do it
back here like this, even if they're looking over the shoulder, you won't see a thing because the camera's looking
over the
shoulder.
Yeah, I suppose so. It is quite good for angles, actually.
Yeah, it's very good for angles. It's an instant reset. It's ready to go again and again. He's got a bonus routine using the same gimmick, which is a very clean coin through hand, where the spectator
has
that.
Good.
Boom.
I actually prefer that to the coin waltz, to be honest with you.
No, I prefer the coin waltz, but it looks very good. He gets the spectator to hold a hand
out. I disagree, because
I think, you borrow a coin,
oh, look, your signature's on both sides. But get somebody's hand, you're holding their hand, and you've got the coin, you go like that, and it's there,
it's
and it
very
falls
clean.
Through.
And he does it also
it
going
looks really
through,
nice. I think
goes,
that's stronger.
He goes through a table as well. He does the same thing where he holds the coin.
I think that's stronger than coin waltz. That's on the same DVD anyway.
It's a bonus, yeah. He's also got an impromptu version of coin waltz, if you want to do the impromptu version, where I think this would be nice.
Didn't like
you
that.
You do anniversary waltz, right?
Yeah.
Have you ever done a crappy coin trick? Shut up. Have you ever done anniversary waltz, right? In a residency situation, and then like the week later they've come in and they've said, oh, can you do that card trick again? You don't want to do the same thing.
No.
You go, well, let me show
you. You do Twilight Angels.
No. You can do exactly the same thing, but you can do it with coins. You can say, well, no, let me try it again, but a different way. Look, the bottom line is, I think it's a really
you
nice
love
plot.
It.
It's a
coin
different
trick.
Coin plot.
It only needs to say coin in the title, and you're like, ooh, great.
Yeah, it's a really good trick. I think that it's very, very good. It's very, very easy. You don't even need to... Okay, you do for a little bit. You hardly need to do any palming. It's incredibly easy to do. It's real work. It's commercial. Admit it, it's commercial.
It's commercial. The moment of magic is beautiful. It looks great. I just don't know if it could connect with an audience, you know, in the way that it looks on the DVD. I know he gets a good reaction and that kind of thing, but I'm not excited about it. But I think it's good.
Yeah.
It's worthy of a release.
Yeah, definitely.
I'm not looking at it saying he shouldn't have brought that out. You know, as you say, he's had a brain fart and we're going to put that on DVD.
No, it's
a good
like
trick.
That.
It's a clever gimmick. He's worth it.
And like you say,
it.
The penetration.
I just don't think I'd do it. But, you know, don't take that into consideration.
Well,
I
think a lot of people would actually do this.
How much are you going to give it?
I'm going to give this 89%. I think it's a very strong release. I think the people that buy it are going to use it. 89%. What about you?
I'll give it 69%.
Oh, come on, Dave. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. No. I'm not going to let you do that. 69%. It's way better than 69%. Just think of the penetration thing.
Yeah,
just think
it.
You
like
just
that.
Said that you would use that.
No, I didn't say I'd use it. I said it was better than coin waltz, and that's a bonus.
Come on, 69%. Surely you can give them a bit more than that.
No, I'm trying to think about my marking a bit more, and you know, it's, if I go above 70, 80, that means I'm definitely going to try it, going to use it sometime.
Exactly, which is why I'm giving it 89%.
No. Craig, are you ready for our next release?
I'm ready.
From Nothing. By Kevin Parker.
That's right, it's become part of the Wizard Product Review. It's that part of the show where we have to suffer through another Kevin Parker.
Oh, we didn't
product.
Have to suffer for long though, did we?
No, because Kevin's upped it. His last DVD was 9 minutes long. This time, he's actually whacked another 2 minutes in. It's an 11-minute DVD, and I didn't think it was possible. But it is. It's possible to watch an 11-minute DVD and think that it's too long. Because he does the same explanation three times.
A lot. I think it's the pauses in between the explanation. But it's nice.
My name's Kevin Parker.
It is nice of him to break off from his decorating.
Oh, yeah.
while he's
seriously,
actually
yeah.
making the
yeah,
DVD.
Yeah, because you watch him and he's in this... I can only imagine it's in his living room and he's got a sofa behind him with, like, being draped over with a dust
sheet.
Cloth, yeah, as if he's in the middle of painting.
And he's gone, hang on, I need some more paint. Let's stick another release out
yeah,
there
let's go whack another
to cover the budget on this next room. Now, there's lots of different magic you can actually do.
Really?
I think there's six tricks, isn't there?
Penetration.
Vanish, appear, levitate,
yeah,
restore.
Transposition.
I think there's six altogether.
Six or seven,
well,
yeah.
Well, now, there's another one that you didn't know existed.
Mm-hmm.
And it's over to Kevin to describe this.
I'm going to teach you how to visually manifest food.
That's right. Food manifestation.
Not just food manifestation, but visual food manifestation. Because that's what it's all about. The mysterious food manifestation. The magician.
A lot's been talked about, you know, with this sort of thing in the magic world before, hasn't it? You know, visual food. It's a bit of an underground thing, visual food manifestation.
It's an entire subculture. Yeah. And here's what it says. The magician hands an empty bag to a person. The person looks puzzled, which I'm not surprised. Magician takes the plastic bag back and produces an apple visually from inside their bag. They see it form through the see-through bag and the apple is handed out for the person to
that
eat.
That sounds pretty... The thing is, though, how do you actually go up to somebody with a clear plastic bag? How do you get into this?
Well,
you're in a restaurant. You're in a restaurant and you go up and you've got a plastic bag. Like,
how do you get into it?
What's your... You'd have to have some, like, really
Kevin covers it.
He covers it.
He covers it on the DVD.
I must have missed
Well, no, it sounds something like this.
You're going to ask them, would you like some free fruit? And who's going to turn that down?
I've got to admit, that's genius.
Yeah. So the basic idea is...
That is genius.
So you go up to a table like this, and you're holding the bag like this, and you go, would you like some free fruit?
That is genius. That
would
pull me
like
in, that
would.
Would
you like some free fruit? But in order for it to work, you've got to be holding it like this in order to walk up to the table.
Yeah.
So you're holding it like this, you walk up to the table... You hope that the people you're performing for don't you think you're some sort of tramp or hobo. And you walk up. You know, if you don't start speaking quickly, maybe they'll stuff some of their food in there.
Let's be fair. Do you know what? I'll go as far as saying this is the best DVD Kevin Parker's brought out to date. Because the moment where the apple, you know, you see this, believe it or not, he's got this bit where he's on the DVD and he goes like this between his legs and you see this thing grow. And you see it grow inside the bag, and then there he goes, there's the apple.
Yeah, you know what? That is actually a really nice subtlety. But you know what? I think that people
think
miss
all right
it.
There.
When I watched
on the trailer, you don't realise that's
I
there.
When I watched the trailer, I said, this is just so rubbish. I showed it five or six lay friends.
Yeah.
And I showed each one of them. And
everyone worked it out,
didn't
they?
All said the same thing. Didn't he just put it in there?
Yeah.
But
there's an extra bit that you can't quite see on the YouTube trailer. For once, the YouTube viewing angle doesn't make it look
and
better
And you've
got to
watch
is.
The trailer, because on the trailer it says Eric Ross. I asked Eric Ross to go out and try this,
and Eric
these
Ross.
Are the reactions that he got. just so rubbish. I can't believe, does this guy actually bother to think about his ideas before he puts them on DVD?
11 just minutes.
No, 11 minute DVD. Worst trick in the world.
No. It's the fourth worst.
Oh, yeah, yeah. You've got Cans and yeah, all the other the crap others, he's brought yeah. out before that. Fourth worst DVD. But does he actually believe... Does anybody... Well, I want to know if anybody's bought this and feels like they've had value for money.
Give it a legitimate review, you know, like angle considerations.
Angle considerations, absolutely. What does he say? He says, oh, yeah, when you walk over to people, you don't have to... You don't want to walk this
you
way.
You
don't
want to. You got
to be straight onto them or slightly to the right. That's the
only... A friend of mine does like a food talk for schools.
Right. You
know, really? Yeah, a healthy eating show for schools.
Okay.
Right. And that's the only time I could think that this could be used.
I just can't see how it could ever be used. There's no professional in the world that's going to walk up with a crappy looking carrier bag and go, would you like some free fruit? My favourite part of the 11 minute DVD, when he was talking about how to justify the bag.
Oh yeah.
He spent 3 minutes talking about, he's like, you got to justify the bag because it's really weird walking up to somebody with a carrier bag without justifying it.
And then he doesn't
didn't
say anything.
Actually justify it. He was like, so you just walk up and you say, this is a mysterious bag. That's not justifying it.
He just says, this is mysterious. And people will think you're mysterious because you're carrying a bag. And that's not justifying it.
And even if you did the trick and people didn't see you load the fruit in there, which I'm pretty sure that everybody will, but even if they don't, it's like, so what? You've made an apple appear. Wow.
I really wanted it to be good.
Really?
I wanted to get surprised.
Well, that Kevin Parker would actually bring a good trick out. At least he's not walking through the park. At least he didn't film it on an iPhone.
It's nothing personal, but it's not very good, again. But I really hope one day... Devon Knight did it. He turned it around.
He did. Devon Knight turned it around.
Let's hope
but we Devon Knight's brought out 70 tricks, so you knew he was going to get it right once. This guy's brought out like 4, 8, 5 or 6. I know you don't like it when I give my negative, like,
yeah,
when
be,
I go into the negative.
Fair.
So, you know, when I give it, like, negative 100 or negative 200. So, as you don't like that, I'm not going to do it, and I'm just going to go for a flat-out 0%. There is no redeeming qualities for this DVD at all, unless, of course, you actually take the DVD out, stick it on your side on the coffee table, and use it as a coaster. That is the only purpose I can see that this would actually have some use in someone's home. 0%.
I think just for the food, healthy living show, maybe it's a possibility you might want to do 5%. Well, coming soon to the Wizard Product Review, we've been filming this, we've been out, we've been getting connected, haven't we? And we've been out in the field, looking at the True Astonishment box set. And we got connected, we went out, we performed some of the material, and coming very soon to a Wizard Product Review near you is... True Astonishment Special Report. And that's from Paul Harris, of course. We have an exclusive on another Paul Harris product as well, which is...
Ink by Michael Chatelain.
It might be Michael, he's in France, you know, that might be the way.
My name is Michael.
And that is a fantastic effect. If you want to guarantee that you're going to be part of the first batch that comes into the UK, you need to pre-order
and
that.
And if you saw the trailer on last week's show, it's just unbelievable. I have no idea.
We'll certainly be taking a closer look at that.
At the Lads Convention.
Having a special report at Lads.
And talking about Lads, you need to get your tickets. There's very few left, is there?
It's nearly sold. Nearly sold out.
Yeah, the hotel that we're holding it in, they've got very strict fire regulations, and they're saying that we've got to cut it at a certain number, and we are very close to reaching that certain number. You have to if you want to have any chance of coming to Lads.
They've got the message, right? Okay. So Etienne's going to be there. Etienne, probably one of my favourite commercial close-up magicians.
Etienne's awesome. I remember seeing him when he did that bill switch thing, and he asked for any bill.
Name a bill, and it just changed.
It's just unbelievable.
He is unbelievable. If you've never seen him lecture before, and I know he's got lots of new stuff in this lecture that he's putting together for the Lads Convention, it's going to be fantastic.
And he fooled Penn and Teller. Garrett didn't fool Penn and Teller.
Garrett hasn't fooled me plenty of times.
Yeah, well, Garrett is the greatest, I've said it before, I'll say it again, he's the greatest close-up magician living today.
And if you're a Garrett Thomas fan,
why aren't you?
If you're going to be in the hotel the night before, or you just feel like coming to the hotel the night before, if you're not too far away, he's going to be doing a special night. Tickets for this have only just gone on sale. We've put it on our Facebook page.
And it's limited to...
It's limited to 25.
25.
25 people. It's £25. And it's a special show.
Oh, yeah.
It's literally like a parlour show by Garrett Thomas
It is absolutely fantastic to see the master of close-up magic.
And then you'll have to be able to have a chat with him and a drink with him afterwards.
Yeah, it's like a show and mix and mingle session. It will be a great start to the lads' convention.
It's going to be awesome.
If you're going to be around on the Saturday night.
And if you're booking tickets, mention World Magic Shop at the hotel. If you're booking in the hotel and you want to stay in the hotel, and they'll give you a special rate.
Special discounted rate. And if you've got food, you want food on the day as well, and you've booked for lads, you have to ring the hotel and book it.
Yeah.
You must book.
Yeah.
Because you can't just turn up on the day and go, I'll have a Sunday dinner as well.
Jim was behind the camera doing that.
Yeah, I think that was his signal.
Was that, Jim, was that your signal to mention food?
Right, next up, Craig, this week.
Psionic.
Jason Poulter's Psionic.
Now we looked at King's Crossing by Jason Poulter, and we met him at Magic Live, and he's a really nice guy. And you know, he's just bought this out, and
Degree Burn is brilliant.
Third degree burn,
where you name any card and you get, it's the blister effect.
Yeah. Third degree burn.
People have, you know, Tim Trono, Greg Wilson, Dan Harlan, I think.
So many people have done things
with a blister
and
effect.
Every other version has basically been, they name a card, you get a lighter, you burn your fingers, and then you show the card, the pip, and the number
blister
is
effect,
there.
Yeah.
Yeah, the blister effect. Now, what Jason's done, he's disposed with the lighter, okay, so there's no lighter,
yeah.
And he's using ESP cards, and he brings out 5 ESP cards, and he spreads them out, and he says, shuffle these, pick any ESP symbol that you want to, look at it, remember it, hold it to your chest, and he doesn't do the lighter thing. He goes, I've got a third eye, and I can look into your third eye,
I think if he actually did that on people, though, there's no doubt he's getting some great reactions.
Look. With a pack of cards, you got a 1 in 52 shot, right? With ESP cards, you got 1 in 5.
No. The thing is, if you're doing it with cards, right? If you're doing it with cards, it's a card trick. Any magician knows, a good magician, you change those pack of cards to tarot cards or ESP cards, it becomes something else. It becomes unworldly. And the spectators, you know, we might think they're gullible or something, but change it to tarot cards or ESP cards, it becomes a miracle all of a sudden.
I disagree. I totally disagree. I think that...
Okay, right. We will take this to the streets.
Yeah.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
And we will test it.
Okay, I'll test it.
No, not you. You're never going to... You're like kids' entertainer, you know, like... Pick an ESP card
while
I make you a modelling balloon.
Shut up. No, there's more to me than a kids' entertainer.
Jimmy won't do it, will he?
Dave, I can be a mentalist.
You can't do it and make a balloon...
You can't make
a balloon poodle.
Shut up. There's more to me than a kids' entertainer. I can blame it up.
You can blame it
I can blame it up. I can go out there and I can blame this trick. I'll blame the hell out of it. I'll go out there and I'll be more Chris Angel than
Third
Chris
eye.
Angel.
Third
you
eye.
Watch me. I'll be like Max Maven and Chris Angel's love child. I'll go out there. I'll do it. And I guarantee you they're going to be like, oh, yeah, whatever.
You don't think it will get a good reaction?
Not at all.
You have to perform it, though. Like Jason suggests.
You watch me.
The third eye.
You watch me. I'll blame it up.
Let's take it to the streets.
Have you heard of the third eye?
Yeah.
You heard of the third eye?
Yeah.
It's right there.
Yeah.
You can see what can't be seen. Mm-hmm. You can feel what can't be felt. Let me give you a demonstration. This is an experiment to find your third eye. What's your name?
Lewis.
Lewis. We've got some cards here.
Okay.
These are ESP cards. They test extrasensory perception, knowing what's going to happen before it happens.
Yeah.
There's 5. That's a star. That's a square. 3 wavy lines, a cross and a circle. 5 cards, 5 possibilities. Lewis, you're gonna touch one. Any one, doesn't matter. Free choice, touch one. Sure, take it.
Actually, no.
No?
No.
Which one
I'll
do you
take
want?
This one.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Wanna change your mind?
No.
Take it. What I want you to do is show everybody, don't show me. Show everybody, you got it?
Yep.
Hold it to your chest. Tight to your chest. Visualize it. In your mind's eye, not in your real eyes, in your mind's eye, visualize it. Can you do that for me?
Yeah.
Right there, visualize it. You're concentrating, yeah?
Yeah.
I'm gonna do this, watch, right here. Send it to me, Lewis, send it to me, send it to me! Now look, on the thumb.
Oh my Jesus Christ.
Look. Show the card, Lewis.
That's nuts. Have you seen this? The stars on his phone.
Is that the most insane thing you've seen?
Lewis, what happened there, man?
I don't know. That's weird, that is, mate.
Were you just thinking of it?
I can't explain. That's nuts.
Lewis, that's the mind's eye.
Brilliant, mate.
Are you okay, man? Have you recovered?
I'm recovered. It took a lot out of me to do that.
Took a lot of energy, that did.
You know
didn't
how,
it?
What you didn't see when the camera stopped? I ran around the corner and made 6 balloon swords.
Just to finish him off.
Yeah, just to finish him off. Yeah.
And then they went away really happy.
Yeah, it's the balloon sword that really impressed him.
Now we had to bleep that guy. His reaction was incredible.
Unbelievable. And I've got to tell you, you're right about the whole ESP cards. And the other thing was, performing it, I didn't realise how easy this is. I've performed Branded and all the other ones. And the problem is, if you know how it works, there's a hell of a lot to do. With this, it's so easy because they've got 1 in 5. It's like, boom, done. 1 second. Yep. And the cards that you receive are so easy to use as well. And
there is an application as well where you can use your business cards and draw on the back.
So you can write,
it goes into a lot of detail, doesn't it?
Takes up hardly any pocket, but it's a worker. It really is. To be honest, if you do mental magic or mentalism, I think that this is going to work for you. I stand corrected. I think that this is as strong, if not stronger, than using a pack of cards.
I think it would connect with people more than a pack of cards. And if you're using that third eye presenter, and even that, he's like the electrician from across the road. He's a real lad, that guy. He goes out and drinks beer, you know?
Yeah, he's a real lad.
And you did that, and he was completely freaked out.
He was just...
We turned the camera off, and he was still talking about it.
Yeah, he was.
When does that happen when you're doing anniversary waltz with coins?
Never. Absolutely never. Hang on a minute. It happens, okay? It can happen. Shut up. Now, I've got to be honest. If I gave 88% to, coin waltz, I've got to give this 91%.
I'm going to give that 92%. I think it's really good.
It's a worker.
And it's very easy to handle as well.
And the gimmick just fits on your keychain. So if you carry your keys around, you're ready to go anytime, anywhere. Very good work, Mr. Poulter. Well done. So the final review on the Wizard Product Review this week is The Rice Papers by Homer Anthony Lee Wag. I didn't know his middle name was Anthony.
I didn't know.
No, Homer Lee Wag.
Wasn't there like a rumour that like Chris Kenner and him were one of the same
person?
Yeah,
yeah, yeah, yeah, yeah. That was a few years ago. You're behind the times now.
Was it?
And then he released Coin 1 and then Coin 2 and now The Rice Papers.
Right, okay.
And got to tell you, this is just amazing. This is just absolutely amazing. There's 3 routines on there and bonuses.
Visual close-up magic.
This
is best.
Visual. Here's a quote. Dave actually said when he was watching this, he said, you know that if this guy entered a magic competition, he'd just destroy everybody.
Everything he does, there's just magic going on all the time.
Yeah.
Handing out a Sharpie's like just some fantastic moments of magic. That was my favourite routine.
We'll talk about that routine first. The first one is, this is what it says about it. It's called marksmanship. A marker is magically extracted from its own cap. A giant ball bearing is produced.
It starts with a small one, doesn't it? The small sort of Sharpie, and it looks like a short version, really. Not a short Sharpie, even smaller.
Yeah.
And he hands it out to people, he says, because he's got his kind of like Magic Club presentation, but then later on in the DVD, he talks about how he actually uses it in the real world, and he hands it to people, and then says, no, you need to take the pen out of it. And that moment is just brilliant.
It's just awesome. You just literally pull a full-size pen out of it. It just looks, you've got to see it to believe it.
And then he goes
on. Then he hands
the
pen out, and then he jams the pen back in, pulls it out, bends it, twists it, just the most amazing stuff. And he goes, oh, it's a ballpoint pen. And he just opens the cap and dumps out a ball bearing like that big.
Huge ball bearing, or you could use an 8-ball or something like that. But he just says, this is actually a ballpoint pen.
And then just when you think it's not going to get any more strange, he goes, of course, this is also a Transformer pen. And he just
turns
into an iPhone.
Into his iPhone.
Now, and turns into it. It's like, it's a pen, now it's an iPhone. And the move he uses to accomplish that, you can do anything with it. So you can make it into a jumbo Sharpie, you can make it into a different coloured pen. It looks amazing. You and I, we're just like, whoa, rewind that. And got everyone in the office to look at it.
It looks fantastic.
Amazing. And you know what? It's a worker. You can see people that use
this DVD is Worker of the Week.
Oh, yeah. Let's no doubt about away. It. And I tell you what, you're going to use that.
You'll get one thing off it. You might use one of the whole routines, but you will get one thing off it.
If you use a pen to sign a card, you're going to want to learn that routine. But the routine I'm excited about is...
More you than me. I love the other routine.
I'm excited about this because you even said, there's your opener. This is now going to be my opener forevermore. I'm going to use this. He does. He walks up to the table. He doesn't have glasses on. And he goes, oh, hang on, I've got a problem with my contact lens. He takes his contact
and
lens
it's not
out.
It's not the I've seen people do this. And it's a terrible a giant gag.
Yeah, it's awful.
Terrible gag where they just go.
You believe he's got right. a problem with his contact lens.
You believe it, and it's the way it appears.
Yeah, because it's not like he pulls a giant contact lens out. He pulls out a contact lens and he goes, oh, I've got a problem with my eye.
The misdirection's fantastic.
Tommy Wonder moment. He looks down. He puts his little contact lens there and he looks down. And when
looks
he look,
up.
He looks
up down
when
again.
Look back
and there
down,
it is on his hand.
Giant contact lens. And he tells you how to get one of these for like $3.
Brilliant.
A couple of quid. And it's just where you get them from. It's just genius. But then what he does is he starts bending it and he goes, it's soft. It's not really.
And then
you
can hand
guy.
It out and it's not
it out,
soft.
Yeah. He puts it away and he goes, of course, the problem is I don't really use contact lenses. I use glasses. And then he produces a pair of glasses.
And the great thing is, in the context of doing all this stuff with a contact lens, you're subtly showing your hand's empty.
Completely empty.
So at the moment you go, bang, there's my glasses and put them on.
And that's great. So if you're a person like me that wears glasses all the time, you walk up to the table without
if
glasses.
If you don't, he's got other applications where he says he wore comedy glasses and that kind of thing.
And he's got that really funny line where he says, I'm a superhero. And, and at the end when he's producing
you don't
glasses, now
you
don't recognise me. It's just brilliant. Genius. Absolutely. The guy's a genius. I'm going to just
You're
totally,
going to nick that line, aren't you?
I'm going to nick that line. I'm going to nick that whole... No, I'm not nicking it. It's on DVD. That is now my signature opener. Anybody ever sees me work in the real world, you'll see me do that as an opener. I guarantee it. And then finally, you've got a card trick.
Didn't like that.
It was all right. You got a...
It was okay. It was three, like, colour checks.
Yeah. What it was a slow... It's the sort of thing that magicians are just going to, like...
On
sit
a screen
in the
at a convention.
Yeah, they're just going to be sitting there going, my God, oh my God. It's like a Harry Met Sally moment for magicians. I'm sure it will be. But it's
in the real world, I don't think you could use it as much.
Yeah. But basically what happens is they pick a card... He fogs it up and it becomes blank, and then it's a slow motion restoration where it happens. It's almost a little bit like Hellbound.
He does show, he shows how to get the gaff, and you don't have to spend any money on gaff cards. He shows you how to make them, and you would be able to use that principle. The methods he uses, the colour changes he uses, are very angly, aren't they?
Yeah. Not that angly, it's a 10 card one.
Yeah, but pretty angly. And all the thing, they work very well for a single view.
By the
and that
way,
sort
here's
of thing.
The thing.
But you could use any colour change.
And here's the
it.
Thing: if you ever wanted to learn the Bertram change, I have never seen the Bertram change taught as well as Homer Leeweg teaches it. It's very well described. If you ever wanted to learn that move, he teaches it on this DVD.
Maybe you'd like that though. It's fair enough. Me saying, you know, it's not my sort of thing. That card trick it wasn't your sort of thing.
It wasn't.
The
my
other
sort
stuff
of thing.
Is so good and so visual. You're slightly disappointed by the card trick.
Yeah, and I know I'm gonna. I mean, I do a lot of stuff with Sharpies. I put that Sharp routine on top, and I know I'm going to use the Sharpie thing, and I also know, as I say, I'm going to use the contact.
Visual close-up magic at its best. You'll get
even
one
though there's
thing
only
out of
three
it.
Routines, there's bonus stuff on there as well. This is awesome, awesome, awesome.
It's fantastic.
It
94%,
really 97%, and worker of the week, unbelievable. Homer Leeweg.
Absolutely fantastic.
You're the man.
And coming up. We've Come got on. An interview from Jeff Price.
Jeff Price. I'll do the impression.
I can't do it now. I have to be in the mood for
but
it.
But Jeff, we met Jeff at Magic Live. Jeff is one of the funniest people I have ever met. I hung around
with
him.
He might not be funny on this interview now. He was funny when we hung around with him.
Yeah, well, honestly.
He brought out gum, didn't he?
He brought out gum, and he's a funny guy.
Gum's great.
When you see him, ask him to show you his real work on Tax Sankey's Tilt. It's brilliant. Such a funny guy.
Fantastic. And he's got something coming out, which he's going to talk to us a little bit about in the interview coming up. I'm trying to get my words out. We're on Facebook. We're on YouTube. That's
we're on the Magic Cafe, don't forget.
For the Wizard Product Review, I'm Dave.
I'm Craig.
We'll see you next week.
You go. You start. No, you want me to start?
I'll start.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll start.
Oh, you'll start.
Okay, so we're here on the sofa with the one and only Jeff Price. Now, Jeff has...
The one and only? I've never heard of this guy.
No, come on. Jeff...
You dragged him over and, like, said, this guy's hot.
Jeff, you remember Gum?
Gum?
Oh, yeah, was that you?
That was Jeff.
Oh, that's Jeff. Right. Oh, yeah, okay. Thanks.
Jeff bought out Gum a couple of years ago.
I remember Gum.
A lot of people look at you as being one of the most creative young minds on the planet.
People look at me like that?
Yeah, they do.
Oh, that's great.
And you're very... you're very active on the Magic
and
Cafe.
Irritatingly, you never stop playing with cards.
Yeah, me and Craig love card moves.
Yeah.
Yeah, I fine. Know. Well, if I was doing an illusion up here, like you that. Probably wouldn't complain.
I probably wouldn't complain,
I'm sorry.
Love it.
It's not really fair, though, is it?
So anyway, we were speaking to your dad, and he said you practice about 14, 15 hours a day.
I'm only up for like 5 hours a day. I wake up at like 1.
You practice.
Yeah, you're
constantly.
A teenager.
Yeah, no, yeah, I am.
You do that.
But yeah,
right,
no, practice. Yes, practice.
And you got a couple of things coming out in the future, very, very soon.
I'm really excited.
The first thing you got coming out is with Paper Crane.
Yeah, Paper Crane.
And what's
called,
that?
It's called Keylicious.
And can we ask? Is there a Paper Crane moment?
No, there's no Paper Crane. I made sure me and Mandy talked about it.
Hang on.
No Paper Crane moment.
Is this an exclusive now?
Yeah.
A Paper Crane DVD.
With no Paper Crane
no
moment.
No Paper Crane moment.
Paper Crane, I'm actually a little bit disappointed with you. You know, you could have just put some random crap out on the table and just had him build it.
There needs
it.
To be a bonus routine.
Yeah, that involves building things.
Yeah, you need to make some cornflake buns or something like that.
I can't do any arts and crafts myself. It's really unfortunate.
But what is Keylicious?
Oh, Keylicious? Oh, it's not like your mom's cooking because it's Keylicious. No,
I don't get that. Sorry.
Delicious,
you don't get
Keylicious.
It's Keylicious.
Oh, right, yeah.
It was a joke.
Okay.
Anyway.
On a different level. I was up till 4 o'clock last night. Go on.
What's it
so
about?
It's a transposition between a key and a key ring. And then they link back together at the end.
It's a very clever gimmick.
Yeah, you've seen it.
I've seen it.
It is very, clever, actually.
Very, very nice.
Have you seen it? Because we were pretending we don't know each other.
It's a visual change, isn't it? We love each other, really. We love each other.
I have a great card move for you after this.
Oh, great. Thanks very much. We had this night.
Surreal moment.
The other night.
The first night that I met them. It was the best.
Jet lag. It was a nightmare. It really was. It was a living nightmare.
Jeff had Dave up until 4 o'clock in the morning, and he was just showing him card move after card move.
Have a look at this one.
It was Craig, too. Craig and I were doing...
There's a point where you just can't be the polite Englishman anymore.
Is that when you stood up, stormed off, and started swearing?
I don't believe.
I didn't think you would be able to. I didn't think anybody would get Dave Penn to stay up until that hour in the morning.
We can
doing
do it again tonight if you want.
I'm into
no,
it.
Actually, I'm busy. I'm busy.
No, you're not.
Yeah, I'm going to see Chris Angel tonight. Oh, so I'm busy.
Look,
yeah,
but after.
I have Chris Angel in my badge. You can't see
really?
It.
Really? Is
he's
he
there.
That thin?
Oh, wait.
All right.
Look, it's Chris Angel.
Yeah, he's a bit of a mind
That's
freak.
Great. Are you a Chris Angel fanboy?
I'm a big fan.
There you go.
He is good. He's very good, obviously.
Yeah, no, he's great.
He's great.
Now, what else have you got coming out?
What have you got coming out?
Oh, I have a new Torn and Restored card called Fuse. Right, Fuse?
Fuse.
Fuse.
Fuse is the name. Everybody asks me to name tricks these days.
And what's
it's like
it about?
A running gag.
What's it about?
It's a Torn and Restored card.
That just
is that it? Sorry, that's been done before.
No,
okay. I've seen.
That's been
Jeff
done
do
before. Torn and Restored.
Basically, we saw it. Well, you showed it to me, and then I dragged Dave over, and I said, "You got to see this."
It is incredible.
You get a card picked, you get a card signed, and then very, very cleanly,
oh, thanks.
You
now
tear
it.
So cleanly, you tear the corner off the card.
Yeah,
and you show it both sides, and then there's
yeah,
so many.
Yeah, both sides. This isn't Kevin Parker brought something out, didn't
oh,
he?
Oh God,
the guy. Have you seen any of his stuff?
I have his Torn and Restored corner.
Do you use any of? Do you use cans?
Do you own a Flasher Mac?
What?
You need to have a
he doesn't
Mac
know what that is. Yeah.
Big a Mac with Mac. Giant sleeves.
Oh, yeah. It's what Craig does on a Tuesday night in
occasionally.
England. Right, so...
anyway, you...
So anyway, Fuse, you rip it off and then you show both sides. It's
and then you show both sides of the card and then it gets fused back on and it's fully examinable.
And the
they
corner
can
be signed,
it.
The card
yeah,
can be
the
signed.
Yeah, the corner can be signed, the
it's
card can
signed.
Be signed.
And they get the card, they can see it both sides with the corner missing, and then it fuses back
yeah,
on.
Yeah, you can show both sides before, after, and during the tearing
and
process.
And you say the best presentation is in the hands of the spectator,
uh-huh.
But you can do it visually as well by
yeah, because I have this belief that flash paper makes everything 5 times better.
That's my line! So you were actually listening when I spoke my words of wisdom the other night. You were.
So flash paper, I don't use fire, but apparently flash paper makes everything better.
Everything better. You can do anything with flash paper.
Yeah.
Do a double lift, put a bit of flash paper on top, light it, then turn the card over.
Yeah.
Reactions times 10.
That's what I heard.
Yeah.
What's your highlight of the convention so far?
Oh, you know, collecting tickets like I am, it's a hoot.
Is it fun being an intern at Magic Live?
Yeah.
You're like the part of the organization team here,
yeah,
aren't you?
Uh-huh.
They're working you hard?
Yeah, I got to watch Greg Wilson's Coffee House Conjuring. That was good.
That was good?
Did he do this?
Why would he do that in a coffee house lecture?
Because he does it all the time.
Because he's addicted. Once he's had 2 cups of coffee, his caffeine, it kicks in.
My
he has to do
Greg.
It.
Wilson.
You don't know that about him?
Yeah, no? It's like an addiction.
Is he behind us? No, that's good.
No, he's not. That's how he's Schwartzman. Yeah. The legend.
Yeah. The Tilt legend.
Yeah.
And
you got a lot of work on Tilt.
I do have work on Tilt.
Yeah, it is. There you go.
I think
we're not going to go there, are we? On camera, though. No.
They don't get what we're talking.
We're not going to go there with that insult to that well-known, famous magician, are we, Jeff? On camera. Oh, would you like to?
Go, Jeff, go for it.
I'm not gonna do it.
Please, go for it.
It's a great impression.
Go on, it was great.
No.
Do it.
No.
Do it.
No, you told me not to.
I was lying. Go on, do it.
Oh, you wanted me to? Okay. No, he's going to get so mad.
No. He's a bald little Canadian. It's fine.
Can we just say the views of Jeff Price aren't necessarily the views of the Wizard Product Review? Yeah.
No. I love
so
it.
So go on, show us your work on
I was just showing... Oh, no, Sankey. You don't think Sankey does... Sankey does a great tilt. My work on tilt is my own
this
work.
This is the Sankey tilt?
Is putting it up... See, most people do it really small. Like yeah. This. That's probably normal.
Yeah.
I put it like 85 degrees.
A little bit like...
I don't think anyone ever has done this before.
Didn't you say a certain name?
No, naming.
I'm sure you said Jay Sankey, and you know Richard Sanders is around here. And
I'm a fan
mates.
Of Richard. I'm a big fan
good
of
fans.
Richard. Yeah.
Good friends, rather. Well, thank you very much for joining us. We really look forward to seeing Fuse
and
in the future.
Keylicious.
And Keylicious.
Yeah.
That apparently is as good as your mum's
no,
cooking.
No, it's not like your mom's cooking. It's Keylicious. That's the line. That's the line in the intro that we filmed with Paper Grain.
I don't get it.
Neither do I.